Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. Today we will be learning about allele's role, which is an important ecological concept. This role actually the extension of Bergman's role. The link of the Bergman role you can find in the description section of this video. This alien rules actually related to the thermal adaptations of warm-blooded animals in the different extreme conditions. This role was formulated by Joel Asaph Allien in 1877, and this is an ecogeographical role. We know that the warm-blooded or endothermic animals have capacity to maintain their body temperatures against the sudden fluctuation of their environmental variations, and they have maintained their body homeostasis up to certain extents by maintaining the internal temperatures. And it is generalized that the warm-blooded animals, particularly in mammals, they have distinct geographical distributions throughout the different biomes, and their extremities like legs, ears, tail, mouth and other appendages tend to have shorter in colder climatic conditions as compared to animals of the same species or race living in warm climatic regions. The alien rule states that the body surface area to volume ratio for homeothermic or endothermic animals varies with the average temperature of the habitat to which they are adapted. That is, the ratio is low in cold climatic regions and high in hot climatic regions. We know that the surface area to volume ratio in case of warm-blooded animal staying in colder region is low in compared to warmer climates of population of the same species, and this adaptive traits can give the opportunity of warm-blooded animal to withstand in the different extreme temperature variations by lowering the heat loss in colder region and increasing the heat loss in the warmer regions like desert conditions. Alien roles also predict that endothermic animals with the same body volume should have different surface areas that will either aid or impede or lose their heat dissipations. And this is observed that if we compare the warm-blooded animals of colder climatic zones with the same group of animals staying in warmer climatic regions, the animals present in the colder climates have short leg or ear or tail in comparison to animal remain in the warm climatic regions because the short ear, leg or mouth the animals having in colder regions reduce their heat loss and by way they can maintain their metabolic activity in the two colder conditions. And while in warmer climatic regions, the animals having large extremes like leg, ear or tails or other appendages have big in size and this big size can help them to reduce heat loss faster so that they can maintain their body temperature in the hot regions like in desert conditions. If we see the animal distributions throughout the different geographical realms, we can found that the realms like Ethiopian realms, Oriental realm, Australian realm and Neolithic realm, which are very close to the equator or near to the equators, the warm-blooded animals, most probably the mammals, having extremities like tail, ear, mouth and other appendages are very big in size. The equator receives the maximum rainfalls and sunlight, and due to this, these four realms, which is present near to the equators, remain hot and humid, and the mammalian species remain in these four realms have bigger or large traits like or extremities like tail, ears in their body, and this helps them to reduce the heat quickly and help in the body temperature regulation in the hotter regions because in these regions the animal's body surface to volume ratio is high and this helps to disseminate the heat loss faster. On the other hand, if we look to the geographical realms like Palearctic realms and Neolithic realms, which is towards the polar regions and remain two poles like Northern America, here the mammalian species have short or small extremities like tail, ears, mouth and other appendages, and these short or small extremities or external appendages give them the opportunity the reduce of heat in very small amounts so that they can conserve the heat to their body and perform the metabolic activity properly. Because in colder regions, the warm-blooded animals having surface to body surface to volume ratio is low, and because of this and their heat loss are also in rate low rate in comparison to warmer regions, and this gives an adaptive advantage to staying in the colder regions. So ultimately we can find that the one-blooded animals present in colder or near to the polar regions have low, short or smaller extremities like tail ears in their body compared to warmer regions or hotter regions of the animals of the same species or race. And by this way, the one-blooded animal can maintain their body temperatures or adapt the extreme conditions in different geographical location. This is all about alien rules. Thank you for watching me.